So if we see the comparison between the gastric ulcers and duodenal ulcers, so these gastric ulcers and duodenal ulcers are going to be, if you see the incidence in the duodenal ulcers is going to be age between the 30 years to 60 years of age group, but in the gastric ulcers are going to be the, over the 50 years. But in the female and also male ratio, in the male ratio it's around to 2 to 3% to in the male, and also is a even 2 to 3 is 1, means 1 will be in the females. So double to the male and female ratio, but in the gastric ulcers is going to be equal in the male and females. So, and also the incidence is going to be 80% are going to be the peptic ulcers in the duodenal regions, that is called the duodenal ulcers, and also only 10 to 15% is going to be the gastric ulcers. So these duodenal ulcers are also going to be more prone and also more common than the gastric ulcers. So the signs and symptoms of the gastric ulcers and duodenal ulcers. So if you see the duodenal ulcers are going to be the hypersecretion of the HCl concentrations. But in the gastric ones is going to be normal or hyposecretions. Maybe is going to be normal or the less secretion of the HCl concentrations. And also may have the weight gain. So here the gastric ulcers may chance to get the weight loss. So the pain occurs 2 to 3 hours. And also here the pain occurs 1/2 hour to 1 hour. So after the meal, the pain is going to occur after the meal, often awake between the 1 a.m. to 2 a.m. In the midnight, this pain is going to be more severe in the duodenal ulcers. So these are going to be rarely occurs in the night time. So these are the difference between the gastric ulcers and also duodenal ulcers. And also ingestion of the food relieves the pain. And also here is going, ingestion of the food does not help. So sometimes increase the pain. So if they take the food inside, so these duodenal ulcers are going to relieve the pain symptoms. But in the gastric ulcers, is not going to be help. Or sometimes if you take the food, the pain is going to be increased. So because of these are going to be, is the gastric, in the, that means in the stomach. So these are going to be the small intestine ulcers. So here the vomiting is uncommon. So because of the duodenum, but this is going to be common. So because it may chance to get the reflex from the stomach and also may regurgitate into the esophagus and also may chance to get the vomiting sensation. And also coming to the hemorrhage, like less likely within the gastric ulcers. So, but it's present in the melina. So that means hemorrhage is going to be lesser, but may be present if it's going to be melina. So this melina means it's nothing but the blood, like a stools. The stools are going to be mixed with the blood. So that is called as melina, more common than the hematematis. So that means going to be blood vomiting is the less, but this going to be the black color stools, or maybe the blood, the stools becomes with the, comes with the sticky blood. So more likely to perforate than the gastric ulcers. So these are going to be, duodenal ulcers are going to be more damaged. So more piercing into the tissues. So it's going to give the large. So if you see here, so these are the gastric ulcers. So these are going to be more perforated. More damage is going to be seen in the duodenal ulcers. So in the gastric ulcers, so hemorrhage more likely to occur than the duodenal. So here is going to be more hemorrhage. And also this hematematis is more common than the melina. So here is going to be the blood vomitings are more. So because of the damage of the mucosa, so because of the bleeding inside the gastric, so it may give the irritation as well as it may give the reflex. So because of this reflex, the esophageal sphincter may chance to get the open. So it may chance to get the vomitings, that's the blood vomitings. And also who are having the duodenal ulcers may chance to get the malignancy or maybe cancers. And these are going to be very occasionally may chance to get the malignancy in the gastric ulcers. So the risk factors for the duodenal ulcers are going to be who are taking the heavy alcohol and also chronic smoking and also H. pylori infections, cirrhosis of the liver and also stress. So these are the risk factors for the duodenal ulcers. And also gastric ulcers also is H. pylori infections, alcohol and smoking, and also non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and stress also. The both are same, but here is gastric ulcers are going to be, especially is going to be more like a effects is going to be in the gastric, in the stomach. So the absorption is going to be in the stomach. So that's why may chance to get the ulcers in the stomach. So because of the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs.